I lived in Austin here a few years ago with a guy from Barnesville, Ohio. And we lived in a one-room apartment, basement apartment, that filled up with water when it rained. And we were would-be fishermen, so it was very convenient for us. But JD wanted to be the Bassmaster of the Universe. He even had a name, Cliff Terhune, Bassmaster of the Universe. And he wanted to go out and catch the 5-pound bass, which he figured was the minimum size for a wall hanger bass. And he talked about it so much that it became a metaphor for anything good in your whole life. You know, like if you got money in the mail, son, that's a 5-pound bass. And if you hook the toaster, son, that's a 5-pound bass. You caught a 10-pound bass, son, that's a 5-pound bass. This is the 5-pound bass. Up this morning before the sun, fix me some coffee and a honey bun. Jump in my pickup, gave her the gas. I'm going out to catch a 5-pound bass. Down by the lakeside, just off the ramp, all them people sleeping in their fishing camps. Some out in the pup tents, some out on the grass. They all be dreaming about the 5-pound bass. Early birdie always gets his worm. Me, I always get my wish. When you're talking about that 5-pound bass, son, the early worm, he gets a fish. Jump in my John boat, I store my gear. I fire up, and when I'm in the clear, I sail across that water as smooth as glass. It's ready, here I come, you 5-pound. Spot some old dead trees back in a canyon where you can't feel no breeze. I time a lure, I make my cast. It's breakfast time, you 5-pound bass. That old sun is rising, that water's clear. I watch my lure as it's flying through the air. I see a ripple. I hear a splash. Lord have mercy, it's a 5,000-pound bass.